And so our IP address for all of our mail basically got blacklisted. You know, I'm just some kid who liked playing with computers, and all of a sudden, you know, I'm responsible for an organization.
It started as a normal day in Greg's life as an admin, but that changed as soon as he got to work.
Anxiety like I'd never really had before. It was, yeah, just sweating and shaking again. And it was, you know, just trying to figure out like, all right, what does this even mean? How could this even happen? I came into work and basically the CEO was standing outside my office. Like I was like coming into my office and I was like, hey, what's going on? And he's just like, nobody's getting my email. And I'm just like, interesting. Okay. And I was like, I'll take a look at it right away, you know? And then within minutes, more people started showing up at the office. And everybody was complaining like, yeah, I'm getting these bounce messages. I'm getting this, I'm getting that. I'm not, you know, emails down essentially for the entire company.
Greg started by looking at logs, a lot of logs. Greg was one of three people in the IT department supporting 3,500 employees. And when those 3,500 employees started noticing that email didn't work, Greg faced a wave of people coming his way. Initially, they just put up a sign to keep people away, but soon that wasn't enough.
The other guy who was in IT with me, he basically just stood outside the door and he's just like, we know there's a problem. Yes, thank you. We know there's a problem. Yeah, you can move along. You know, it's just like, and I mean, half the people just ended up going home because without doing email that day, like they couldn't work. And so it's just like, well, I'm just going to take a half day. It's like, please stop bothering us. Yeah.
With people out of his way, Greg was able to concentrate on the task. And soon he discovered an email queue of more than 90,000 emails.
That company was the first time when I actually got my hands onto Exchange Server. I mean, as an admin, unless you're at a small shop, like nobody touches that Exchange Server. I mean, nowadays everybody just shoves it in the cloud because nobody wants to deal with Exchange. Nobody, ever. What I first did is I started sending emails to our own server and to like, you know, Gmail and stuff like that. And then I started looking at the actual records and the logs and seeing, okay, we're landing in spam or we're getting blocked completely. And then I saw Blacklist. The hell's a Blacklist? I'd never even heard of Blacklist before. And so I looked through research and I'm like, oh, interesting. And then you can look up, you know, by your IP, if you're on a Blacklist, which Blacklist you're on. And it turned out, yeah, we had landed on one of the most prominent ones. And that's then picked up by like, you know, the Norton spam filters and the Gmail spam, but like those, they check these spam lists constantly, which is really interesting because I found that the Blacklists, they're not so strictly controlled or regulated in any way. It's kind of like the Wild West, but yet at the same time, if you land on one of these things, like your business is screwed. Like you can't send mail. Basically, I was like, oh, this must be a mistake, you know? And so I emailed the guy and I was like, you know, this is, you know, whatever. I don't know what happened. You know, we're taking a look at it. You know, can you take us off the blacklist so we can send email again? He was kind enough and he did that, however it was. And yeah, we were able to send email then for a day or two. And then I come back into the work and the same thing. But this time it was like three or four blacklists. And I'm just like, oh, Christ, like what is going on now, you know? And so I started doing more research into like why this happens and so on and so forth. And then again, looked at the firewall and we'd actually blocked this port before we'd blocked the BitTorrent ports. But yeah, we blocked in port 25 for SMTP going out. And that stopped the problem, but then going back and trying to get off those, like, cause it had just started propagating. And I think by the end we were on like, I don't know, 5, 6, 7, 8, something like that, different blacklists. And the one who had taken me off originally is like, listen, you know, third strike though, I'm taking you off the second time, but third strike, like you don't come off, like you're gonna have to buy a new IP address or something like that. And I was just like, okay. Like, and just hoping to God that I was like, did something right. And you know, I knew what I was doing, which I totally didn't. So after that, we figured out, you know, because we blocked the port, we could see the outgoing requests from all the computers that were trying to send nefarious email directly. And yeah, we got their laptops and oh God, it was like those situations where the browser has like 15 or 20 toolbars at the top. And like the browser window's only this big, you know, at the end of the day. I mean, the things had so much malware on them. We basically just had to completely nuke them and restart from scratch.
So now we know what to do when something like this happens. And most important, you want to catch it as early as possible. But what can you do to prevent this altogether?
Yeah, so I mean, when you're talking about email and stuff like that, and you land on a blacklist, you need to know as soon as possible so you can start addressing it, because otherwise it's just gonna spiral out of control very, very quickly. You know, I'm not gonna sit there and look at the exchange queues all day and just hit refresh. I don't know, nobody has time for that. And so you set up monitoring. And so what we did is we set up monitoring for our exchange queues. So the outgoing mail queues, we set up the PRTG, the round trip sensor. So it basically sends mails out and then sees if it comes back. obviously. And then there's also the IP or the DNS blacklist sensor. So basically, it will check all these blacklists that are out there. Probably not all of them. There's probably more of them. I don't know. But the main ones that are important for most spam filters, it will check them for your IP address and tell you, you know, if you land on one of them, yeah, before no email can be sent out. When you land on the blacklist, you know, if getting off of one is bad enough, you know, you don't want to have to get off of 5 or 15. Or, I mean, I read horror stories on the internet. Oh my God, you know, sometimes it'll take you weeks, months to get off all the blacklists.
But the question remains, why did some of the workstations send out spam anyway?
Basically, somebody's workstation got infected with malware and somebody started using it for a botnet. And so the botnet actually spread a bit within our network. We had mandatory antivirus on all the computers, but people were able to obviously get around it. Then they downloaded stuff that they weren't supposed to and got malware on the computers. And then basically they started turning into email spammers. And yeah, the emails basically started originating from specific workstations. Because there's those workstations were inside of our network, again, it was going out through our main IP address, and so our IP address for all of our mail basically got blacklisted.
To learn how the malware landed up in the network in the first place and what you can do about it if you're ever in that situation, click here.
That was a fun couple of weeks. I didn't sleep much.